closed signs, a very familiar sight. We've seen it today for many drivers as rivers breach their banks.
Major roads in West Dallas closed early this morning due to the river. And that's where we join 12 News Craig McKee.
Good evening, Jason and Toya. I actually have some good news to pass along tonight. You can see here, this is the Root River back into its banks. That is the good news, but look at the mess it left behind. We have mud all over the roadway here along the parkway. We still have some standing water over in this area and some of the neighborhoods along the parkway here. And this is still the only road in West Dallas, which is also good news, that still has barricades up trying to keep as much traffic out of the area. But we can take a look at some video of what this area looked like just a few hours ago. And you can see some serious flooding issues here. Flooded roads, not only here, but in other parts of West Dallas, one of several roadways shut down. Mid-morning, though, some of them opened back up, except for the parkway. Days of rain adding up in the front yard as well for Larry Borick's house. Water pooling in his ditch there. We found the 76-year-old hard at work with a rake, shovel, hoe, anything he could, just trying to get the water to flow again.
Because right now it's all built up with dead grass and with dead leaves and dirt over the winter when they plow, stuff gets shoved in there. So it kind of builds it up. So what I'm going to do is pull out all the dead stuff and then try to take the shovel and dig out a little bit more.
As you can see, he actually lives in one of the neighborhoods along the Root River here. Now, the major situation, of course, in Milwaukee as well. WISN 12 News' Nick Bohr is along the KK River. Nick, we understand the level there in the river is much above the regular level.
Right, Craig, well above normal. The KK River, a lot of times just a trickle through here, but take a look. Obviously, the water well above that right now. Water racing through this portion of the river along 10th Street, adding to the flow, raw sewage mixed with rainwater. The MMSD tells us they had to make the tough decision this morning to release without treatment. It is clear, or maybe not so clear, from the different color of the flow into the river, not to mention the odor, that the waters swirling out of this pipe are a portion of the millions of gallons of raw sewage mixed with rainwater being released into the Kinnikinnick River. The river flow itself gives an indication of how much rain has fallen in the area. So fast, the Milwaukee Fire Department is scouting out the area east of 6th Street because the so-called fast water danger it poses. But maybe more telling, the 430 million gallon deep tunnel far below the surface filled in a matter of hours.
Since the midnight, we've had anywhere from 2 to 3 inches of rain in the area, and the tunnel system started filling up very quickly with the rainfall overnight, and at 4:30, approximately 4:30 this morning, I authorized a combined sewer overflow to begin.
The MMSD's Kevin Schaefer says they first tried emergency combined sewage treatment at Jones Island Wednesday, allowing them to get an extra 100 million gallons through the plant before it was overwhelmed. And because the tunnel is still nearly full, the overflow is expected to last for days.
Once the rain stops, you still have all that water in the ground and all that water that's running off the surface that's getting into the sewers. It's running somewhere. So we'll be dealing with water for 24 hours, probably just trying to catch up with everything that's coming in.
Of course, the deep tunnel was built to prevent sewage from backing up into people's basements, and we've had very few reports of that despite the torrential rain.